What's up, UC? Let me start by telling you how cool it feels to stand at this podium today. I am beyond honored. I'm honored to be the speaker for this class of 2021. I'm honored to join a list of incredible people who have been in the position I'm at today. I'm honored to represent my God, my family, and my friends who are all a part of this just as much as I am. Firstly, I want to thank my wife, Brittany, for supporting, challenging, and loving me through my entire journey. Family and friends who have been and continue to be there, thank you. It's love always, and it's an honor to be in your lives. I also want to thank and recognize those I met while at UC who had a significant impact on my time here. The three incredible women I met in the library, Stacy, Anna, and Rebecca, you guys get the first recognition because you are and continue to be the heart and soul of the campus. Thank you for the unconditional love and support you gave and taught me during my many hours in the library. I met many other great people at that front desk and had conversations that serve as some of my better memories at UC. Front office, cafeteria, custodial, security, and other members of the school's community, thank you. Kelly and Glenn down at the bookstore, you two always had my back, and I appreciate you guys. Dr. Serafin, Dr. Haas, Dr. Sun and Watson, and many other great teachers and mentors, thank you for your commitment to me and my learning through my years at UC. My classmates, I thank all of you. My roommates, CJ, Jalen, Willard, and Jorge, I appreciate you guys and we will always be a part of each other's lives. The guys on the football team, past and present, thank all of you for the brotherhood we shared on that field and in the locker room. Mike Nyquist and the rest of the training staff, thank you guys for your commitment to making sure I was ready to go on game day. All my coaches, Coach Kirkland, Paul Johnson, Zach Johnson, Coach Quinn, Butler, Freeland, Santala, Mitchell, Howard, Hill, Eberhardt, and Albright. Thank you for the opportunity to play college football. We fought through many highs and lows and won a lot of great games together. Lastly, I want to thank President Roth and the others who are responsible for bringing me here today. It is an opportunity I could not let pass by, and again, I am very, very honored to be here. Graduates, congrats on finishing what you started. It's an accomplishment you can be forever proud of. All the early mornings, late nights, tests, essays, labs, finals, presentations, you did that. Studying, reading, writing, studying some more, even when you didn't want to, you did enough to get that degree. Take pride in yourself and enjoy this high in your life. Many of us are the first to graduate college in our family. Many of us are even the first to attend college in our family. Many of us are continuing the greatness that has been on display in our family for many generations. Or maybe you're just somewhere in between. Whatever the case is, you did something special. You secured your bag and no one can take it from you. I have a lot of great memories from UC. I still remember getting in that bubble suit at the school lawn events. This one time I ran full steam into a girl about half my size and sent her 20 yards the other way. Don't worry, she asked me to. I also remember being part of the student section, supporting all our other sports teams. We would insult the opposing team, insult the ref even. We'd go as far as to make animal noises, anything to give the UC team the advantage. This one time, my friend Michael Farhat grabbed the game ball, chucked it at the hoop, he missed horribly and got it stuck in the wall mount, delaying the game for a good 10 minutes. Oh, and of course, we were always down to hype up the toast man. Hanging out in the dorm rooms and going downtown was always fun. I always thought it was cool to hang out with all the different people that came through to UC. Different childhoods, different struggles, different perspectives, all merged into one small college campus. I had some great times while I was here, and I'm sure you did too. Okay, so maybe I've been out of school for only 2 years, but I've learned a lot of great lessons in life already. I've learned to be excited about buying silly adult things like my brand new silverware set, house plants, and my lawnmower. I've also learned that wineries and breweries are a far more enjoyable experience than a bar or a club. Things you might not be able to understand just yet, but you will. I've also learned the typical tough guy, hard work pays off, or our struggles make us stronger, or no excuses, get it done. Things you might guess an NFL player would learn in their first 2 seasons. While all this is important, these attitudes just aren't enough to give you what you want. I've learned that simply toughing it out to reach a certain goal will leave you feeling this sort of void or emptiness once you do get there. You can't expect your happiness to multiply just because you get what you want. Trust me, being drafted into the NFL was a heck of a morale boost and certainly checked off goals that I've had since I was a kid. But the accomplishment alone wasn't enough to fulfill me for a lifetime. I learned that I can't invest every bit of my self-worth into what I do because once it's gone, then what? I personally believe the biggest flaw in our minds is thinking that when we reach a goal, we will be happy. But I challenge you to ask yourself, why am I striving to reach my goals? Why do I push through the hard days? Why do I do what I do? Today, I want to help you find out why and better define your why. And my quote for you guys today is, accomplishing something is not where you find happiness. I believe happiness is found when you regularly reflect on why you accomplish. So I have five areas where I believe that your why exists. These areas include family, spirituality, overcoming struggle or trauma, pride in your job field, and pure competitive nature. It may exist in just one of these areas, or maybe all five. But first, let's talk about family. I think striving to make a relative proud is a very strong why. Parents, grandparents, brothers, sisters, whoever, I feel that a desire to impress your family or doing right by them could push you through anything you want and give you a confident purpose. I have a lot of great people in my life, and of course, I want to be something they can be proud of. When I don't want to get up in the morning, I can just think of my family, or I can think about my wife and the life I want for her. That's plenty enough to jump me out of bed and get started with my day. The next area is spirituality. Spirituality is another one that I feel is a very strong basis for your doing. Not just the idea of a God, but also loved ones who have passed that serve as your present day guardian angels. Making decisions as if God or your angels are watching will lead you to exactly where you were meant to be. For me, it's a combination of both. I want to bring glory to my God, and I want to make my guardian angels smile. The next area is where I find a lot of my own why. It's the fact that you have overcome or are currently overcoming some sort of struggle or trauma. I think it's very safe to say that we've all experienced some sort of extreme low in our life. I've fought through struggles in my family, fought through the self-doubt heading into college football in the NFL, and I've felt alone even when all the stage lights were all over me. Fighting through that and becoming who I am today is something I can put my pride in. There have came points when I've reached rock bottom, where I questioned everything I was doing and couldn't see an end to the rut I was in. Guess what? I'm rocking it today, and so are you. You're here, achieving something very special, and you will continue to do great things. Then, after we've won our battles, we meet others who have been through or are going through something similar. We can then offer advice and support because we have experienced that low, and now we are a testimony to them that yes, it is possible to overcome those obstacles, and then some. Being able to relate to someone's trauma is a very powerful thing, so yeah, take pride in that. Own your journey, and continue to write your amazing stories so that you can help others write theirs. The fourth area is your loyalty to the job field, or just a passion for your job field. The best example I can think of is healthcare workers. The great nurses are the ones who live for the moments of just putting smiles on their patients' faces, or when they see families cheer after a loved one overcomes a deadly illness. Another example could be a teacher. Most teachers understand how big of an impact they have on their students' lives, and that alone is an incredibly strong, purposeful life. And just a reminder, you could have your goals within these jobs, and you'd be happy to get a promotion or better pay, but reflecting on your purpose through the process of getting to that promotion makes you invincible. All right, so maybe you aren't into all the soft-hearted stuff just yet. You might just be a tough, gritty person who's driven by your own pure competitive nature. A chip on your shoulder can be a great motivator, and the satisfaction of proving those doubters wrong may be just enough for you. Or, if you're like me, you want to prove it to yourself. I think we all have a negative voice that is always against us, always challenging our self-confidence. But there's nothing better than shutting that voice up by walking headfirst into that challenge and absolutely owning it. Nothing better than knowing how scared I was by this university and college football, than becoming both the Defensive Player of the Year and an Academic All-American. Nothing better than knowing how scared I was by the idea of the NFL, than grabbing Derrick Henry by the waist and throwing him into the turf. And now, I can look myself in the mirror and know that nothing, not even my own self, can get in my way. So whether it's your family, your spirituality, your life's testimony, your passion or loyalty to your job field, or just the dog competitor in you, finding purpose in your life and why you do what you do is what I would consider the secret to happiness. Thanks again to my family, my friends, my God, and all members of the UC community, and congratulations to all of you 2021 graduates. Enjoy this victory and go UC.